Everything is all about looking after your mate. Prioritise someone else and get reward by doing it.
Truly believe in bettering ourselves as people, for our footy club, for each other and for our community.
So it was pretty close, and for that reason, he's won.
2 full days, just on big one.
The Adelaide Crows have selected Riley Filthorpe.
Thank you.
Got a few of the boys.
How you going?
Sorry to interrupt.
Hello.
How you going? Welcome to the nest.
As a club, AFLW has made us more diverse and a better place to be.
That split second, Jimmy, that's unbridled emotion, and I saw it in my son.
So that's our goal for this year, putting out a performance on the field that our members and supporters can be proud of, but also one where you walk off head held high. We put everything out on the park and left nothing to chance.
Hello and welcome. I'm Mark Bickley and we are coming to you live from the Adelaide Football Club at West Lakes with Crows Live. Now, we'd like to welcome everyone that's tuning in, whether it be on the website, the app or on Facebook. So it's going to be a great night, I'm sure. Before we kick things off, the Adelaide Football Club would like to acknowledge that the land we meet on today is the traditional land of the Kaurna people. We respect their spiritual relationship with their country. We also acknowledge the Kaurna people as the traditional custodians of the Adelaide region, and their cultural and heritage beliefs are still important to the living Kaurna people today. Coming up tonight, we'll hear from both Crows senior coaches, Matthew Nix and Matthew Clark. Some Crows favourites will be answering some questions from the fans, and we'll go inside the inner sanctum of training.
From an on-field
but as you can see behind me, the Crows AFLW side is training on Footy Park in preparation for the first game of 2021. That's going to take place in just a few days' time. And I'm rapt to be joined by the Crows AFLW skipper, newly crowned skipper, Chelsea Randall. Chelsea, welcome to the show.
Thanks, Bix, and hello to everyone else watching.
Firstly, it is slightly different for you. Aaron Phillips stepped down as the co-captain. You're going to be doing it on your own this year. What are your expectations?
Oh, it's I'm feeling really proud, and you know, it's a big responsibility, and obviously just following in the amazing legacy that Aaron has left behind, and it doesn't change much from her part. She still leads in her own natural way, and expectations, I guess, for us this season. You know, it's one game at a time, but our girls, it's a great vibe at training. You know, we've got great relationships, and we're feeling like we're in a really good spot at the moment.
Well, that was going to be my next question. You've got the first game coming up this Saturday. You've had a few changes. I guess it's really the team that can adapt really quickly and just, you know, take what's in front of them that's going to do well this year.
Most definitely. And it's obviously such trying times with COVID and bits and pieces. You have to have that element of being able to be flexible and being able to be, you know, adaptable to different situations. We see GWS are obviously hubbing here in Adelaide at the moment, and who knows, you know, if that is going to happen to, you know, the likes of our team or bits and pieces. So yeah, being able to be flexible off the field with our jobs and everything, but also on field, it's about that fierce, competitive, relentless efforts that we'll be hoping to bring to the track.
Now, Chelsea, up for a few questions from the fans.
Sure, let's fire away.
Let's kick one off from Rob at Walkley Heights. He says, or he asks, do you feel that you'll perform the same as you did pre-injury, or will you take a slightly different role when you come back?
Yeah, I'm actually with the knee, I'm feeling really good at the moment. So had a really good rehab process over the last 12 months. It's about 671 days
really?
Since
who's
my
counting?
Last... Who's counting though? But since my last AFLW game, so I'm just really pumped to be able to get back out on the track and play with my mates, and felt like I was able to trial that in the game against GWS in the trial match. And yeah, still was able to do everything that I was able to do before, so feeling confident.
Went up forward too there, I see.
Yeah, had a crack up there.
Okay. Well,
contributed to some of those points.
Yeah, just the 21, we won't mention that. Next up, Wendy from North Haven. Having won two premierships already, what do you do to keep the team focused and motivated, and how are you going to achieve that this year?
Yeah, it's something that's, you know, can be quite challenging, because you can never be satisfied, and I don't think, even though we've had the two premierships of that success, you can let that sink in. And I think you're only really, I guess, just appreciate how amazing that was when I retire and when my career's kind of done as a footballer. So for now, it's, you know, we're not here to participate. We're here to compete. And that's what these girls have, you know, done an amazing pre-season. And hopefully that's what our fans can come down and see and watch us on the track and do that.
Well, that's great to hear. Now, finally, Amelia from Woodcroft says or asks, where do you see yourself in 10 years' time, maybe after football? That's assuming you've retired in 10 years' time.
Oh, 10 years. Jeez, what would I be? I'd almost be 39 years old there, so I'm not sure if I'll be playing. But, yeah, who knows? I'd love to be in the sporting industry.
Yes.
Love to keep my options open, so doing a little bit of radio media, also working, done some coaching and stuff previously, also a director on the Children's on the Crows Foundation, volunteering on that. So, yeah, lots of different things that I've doing and also studying my teaching degree at the same time. So plenty for me to keep busy as well as footy. So hopefully some doors open when my career ends.
Well, let's just hope you're still at the Adelaide Footy Club in one capacity or another. Chelsea, thank you very much for joining us this evening.
No worries. Thanks, Bix.
Okay, there you go. Chelsea Randall, the sole captain of the AFLW Crows team. Now, the club's AFL side has been working hard off the track with just weeks before their first game of 2021. Now, we had a chat to senior coach Matthew Nix. Here's what he had to say.
From an on-field point of view, it comes back to consistency. I think the way we finished the season in 2020 was a really positive way to finish. You know, the last six games, we were quite proud of what we put out on the field. So that's our goal for this year, putting out a performance on the field that our members and supporters can be proud of, but also one where you walk off head held high as a player and as a group, that we've put everything out on the park and left nothing to chance. Having some great experience come on board from a coaching point of view has been a real positive for us. You know, Scott Burns coming in, and he's immense experience from years and years in the game. James Raleigh bringing some IP from a really high quality club in Geelong, and then Nathan coming back, a legend of the club and a former captain, outstanding character. You know, to have him working through our midfield is going to be a real positive for us going forward. You know, due to COVID, due to border closures, protocols around what our players could and couldn't do, we had a number of players that stayed around, and we had a group that were hungry to get better, and watching them throughout the break, putting their bodies through some tough training, we've come back in really good condition. We've put ourselves in a great position now to get our football right, so we're well and truly into match practice, into a number of breakdown drills, and I'm confident our guys are going to be fitter and stronger this year. It's now a matter of us getting our football consistent. Well, there's some rule changes which may change the way the game looks. Some of the man on the mark stuff is really interesting going into 2021. It's a good challenge for us as a group, as a coaching group especially, is to try and predict what this is going to do to the game. I'm hoping it speeds the game up. I think we all like to watch a fast game of footy. We like to attack, we like to take the game on in offence, and some of the new rules are going to hopefully help in that area. I think you'll see a slightly more attacking game plan. You may see more players taking the game on off of a mark rather than going slowly. For all those footy fans out there, hopefully we see a game that's a little faster than what it's been the last few years.
Great to see that the pre-season looks like it's well on track. A little later we're going to hear from two-time AFLW player Dana Cox, but it's now time to chat to AFL defender, star defender Tom Doday. First of all, Tom, Roy Sloan was going to join us, but he had other commitments. We are rapt that you have filled in for us.
Thank you, Bix.
How are you feeling, two-thirds of the way through the pre-season?
Yeah, body's pretty good. A couple of little niggling injuries, had 4 stitches in the eyebrow, a little cut on the neck, but that's what we get used to in pre-season.
Who did you run into? So who's got the hard head?
Well, I actually don't know yet. I haven't checked the vision. I'm hoping it's one of the younger boys so I can get into him after it, rather than the big boys that I might have a bit of trouble with. But no, it's been good. We're back full training, and to not have any of the bigger COVID restrictions like last year where we can full contact, full noise, it's been great.
Your own season last year was a bit interrupted with injury. How excited are you that you hopefully you're going to get away and get some continuity with your football this year? Because when you did play, you must have been wrapped with your form.
Yeah, it was good just to play a few games in a row, especially after missing all of 2019. And I've put in a fair amount of work over the break. Obviously, with COVID, I was staying around here because going back to Victoria was a bit of a risk. So, with the physios every day, I've tried to do everything right and ready to roll in. We're pretty much full noise in pre-season. The only thing I'm missing is a couple of conditioning sessions here or there, which is more just to do with monitoring load. But all in all, it's been pretty good.
Matthew Nix mentioned in the package about the last six rounds last year, some momentum. Are you confident you can carry that into season 2021?
Yeah, I think so. I think we've got a young group that was learning on the run last year, especially if you think of the boys that debuted a bit later on, Harry Schomburg, Lockie Scholl, Jordan Butts. They've, instead of resting on their laurels and hoping that it all happened again, they've actually put more work in over the off-season. They've all come back in great nick, and I don't think there's any complacency in this group.
Great. Okay, time now for some questions from some of the fans. Here we go. Fotis from No Longer Down says, we've got some exciting young players emerging. Which players have impressed you the most during the pre-season?
Yeah, great question, Fotis. We've got a few. I think Will Hamill's come back in really good nick. He's put on a bit of size. He's really worked on his kicking at speed. Jordan Butts, as I said before, he's come back bigger. Joshy Worrell's put on a bit of size.
Going to take your spot, those two boys.
Yeah, they are. I'll try to keep them down a bit, actually. But Jacko Hatley's come over from GWS. He's done really well. He's running well. And then Lockie Scholl's winning pretty much all of our running events. So that's probably five, but I'm doing a disservice if I don't mention all the other boys. We've all returned in great nick, and it's been great to see those younger boys put in the work.
That's good to hear. Siddharth from Hamlin Heights says, what specific strategies have been put in place to create better defenders and better forwards this season?
Yeah, that's it's an interesting one. We've worked, without getting too much into the nitty-gritty of our game structure, we've worked with the forwards on having a bit more structure down the line. So rather than just kicking and hoping, we're working down there in terms of giving them an opportunity. And then defensively, we're installing a few different things, just better connection as a group. So rather than just the forwards pressing up to their men and mids holding back, or rather than just the defenders working as a group, it's more of a team effort. So we put a few different things in. We're working on them. Obviously, last year we didn't start as well as we would have liked to, but hopefully what we've put in now is going to pay dividends when it comes to round one.
Yeah, I'm sure it will. Now, finally, Andrew from Davern Park says, what do you see as the team's biggest challenge ahead of the 2021 season?
Yeah, Andrew, I think our biggest thing will probably be a bit of complacency after winning three or four games last year, especially with the young group. I think there might be a bit of a thought of maybe it'll just happen again, considering how we finished the year. But it's been great to see that our younger boys, like I said before, have put in a ton of work over the break. PBs in 2Ks, PBs in bench press, bench pull, out on the track being elite. So I don't think that complacency is there. But in terms of going into the year thinking it'll all happen again with a younger group that's not as experienced, that might be our biggest issue. But at the moment, it seems like it's not going to be an issue at all.
Well, Tom, thanks so much for joining us. Good luck for you personally for the year, and good luck for the team.
Thanks, Pix. Appreciate it.
There you go. Tom Duday there, just joining us and answering your questions. During the week, we actually sent our cameras out onto the field to get the sights and the sounds from Footy Park. And of course, Matthew Nix features strongly.
Okay, VB's coming out with the board. It's got three teams on it. Okay, one team will be over doing a handball game. The other two will be supersetting it over here with a strong side game. All right, one third, two thirds. We'll have a look at the board. What are we working on in the strong side game? Detail man on the mark, yeah?
Striking distance.
There's a lot we're working on. So I want to see more of your speed, yeah? I want you to see you drop the hammer. Whenever you get a chance, I want it to be at the speed that you got, which no one else has got, eh? So that there, that lead by Nettie, that's you. Bam! No one's going to go with you. If I'm defending you here, am I stopping that?
No.
Yes, I am, mate.
Huh?
Yes, I am. So work me over. Too easy, too easy. What? Bang, bang, bang!
Yeah, keep it.
Roll and go, roll and go, roll and go! Roll, roll! Nice, bud, nice.
You got Bill.
Yep. Play on, come on, go. Oh, nice, Rock. Good speed, Rock.
Welcome back. Live pitches behind us. We're live at West Lakes here at the Adelaide Football Club, and we're very lucky because a man who's in huge demand is veteran forward Tom Lynch, who's just stepped off the training track. Tom, firstly, welcome. Thanks for your time. Tell us about your new role. You're an assistant coach now with the AFLW team.
Yeah, so first, I don't like hearing the veteran tag, but thanks for the welcome. Yeah, it's great. We're obviously out here at the AFLW train tonight, and they're all here. Look at them.
It's a nice reception.
Yeah, it's a nice reception.
Made an impact.
Yeah. Someone else on the ball? Bit of carry on, but I am fortunate enough to be a part of this group, which is a lot of fun, and obviously first game this weekend, so it's we're all really looking forward to it.
As we said, you're enjoying the coaching. Is that something maybe further down the track that you could see yourself being involved, staying involved in a footy club once your playing finishes?
Yeah, certainly. I'm really enjoying it, and being a part of the girls' program is just a great opportunity for me, but also the footy club to keep aligning those two programs of both the men and the women. And both groups are work pretty closely together now. Obviously, the COVID rules have hindered that a little bit, but there's certainly a huge amount of respect, obviously, for the two-time premiers out here.
Yeah, well, let's talk about the men's side now, which you're a huge part of. The forward line is a very inexperienced forward line. You brought some younger players in through the draft as well. What sort of role have you been playing out on the training track?
Well, first and foremost, they're a really young, dynamic forward line that seemed to be developing really nicely. There's some great names in there like Himmelberg, Fogarty and Phil Thorpe, and these boys are really training really well. And, my role especially is just to keep competing, to make sure that I'm driving the standards for them. And obviously, naturally, through being a teammate, we help and teach and develop. But the main thing I can do, and some of the other senior leaders like Tex down there, is to make sure we keep competing and make sure they take our spot, and that's the best way we think we can make those guys develop quickly.
Has anyone beaten you on the track yet? Any of those young blokes?
Yeah, too many times, I think.
Hey, Tom, thanks for having a chat with us. Good luck.
Cheers, mate.
Both as an assistant coach with the women and also for your own form this year.
Thanks, mate. Cheers.
Okay, time now to take a look at the pre-season. It's number 5 for the AFLW. Can you believe how quickly that has gone? We're going to take a look back from the team photo to last week, the trial game against GWS.
The Adelaide Crows select Tia Charlton from the South Adelaide Football Club.
Sorry to interrupt.
Hello.
How are you going? What number are you thinking you want to be for the Crows?
I would love to be 25.
Right. Well, abracadabra.
Whoa.
There it is.
Look what we have.
Now joining us straight off the track, two-time premiership player Dana Cox. Dana, welcome, and just days away from the first round. That's exciting for you.
Yeah, it's awesome. I'm really looking forward to it. Obviously, with COVID, there's been a bit of a shake-up, but season's been brought forward a week, which I think the girls are actually stoked about, and really looking forward to kicking off season 5.
A lot of enthusiasm out on the track. I guess pre-season comes to an end pretty quickly, and you can finally show everyone what you can do. And are you expecting good things this year?
Yeah, absolutely. As you said, when pre-season ends, everyone gets a bit more of a pep in their step, ready for game day. Really looking forward to the season. Yeah, it's going to be a ripper, I think.
Okay, tell us about some of the stars through the pre-season. Who can we expect that may have improved significantly when we watch the game on Saturday?
Yeah, I think a couple of the newish girls that have had a season and a full pre-season under their belt. So I think Chelsea Bedell and... we got money over from Western Bulldogs as well. And also, I'm really looking forward to watching EJ.
Yeah.
I think she's really grown as a player and a person, and I think she'll show that on the big stage.
Yep, Eloise might be in. Is she in the leadership group this
year? Yes,
she's in the leadership group. Well done to Eloise there. A few new recruits as well this season. How are they shaping up?
Yeah, really good. As I said, we got money over from Western Bulldogs, and she's got silky smooth skills, which we're really looking forward to seeing her put on show. And also got Sedgie. back from St Kilda. So, yeah, she's a real competitor, so looking forward to having her on the team again.
Well, Dana, we look forward to watching you play on Saturday. Congratulations on getting through another pre-season and good luck for the year.
Thank you.
There you go, Dana Cox, two-time premiership player with the Adelaide Crows. Now, still to come, we hear from AFLW senior coach Matthew Clark, plus we're also going to hear from the new club chairman, John Olsen. Now to the Crows supporter group, which has stuck by the club through its toughest time. We caught up with supporter group president Peter earlier this week.
Well, basically we just had to pull together the main committee and sort of work on what we can do with our fans to interact them with what we can do. Whilst we had spatial seating, I was really happy with what the club enabled us to do, and that was the supporters group, to be able to have first line tickets available to us before they went to general public. But we kept in touch via Zoom and network platforms to enable us to keep our committee strong and going together. Well, we're hoping to get back to having our sportsperson's nights, or sportsman's night if you like it, and some other interactions with the group. On the 6th of March, I think it is, we've actually got our first proposed event. Hopefully we can get some people along to that and try and raise some funds. It was very difficult last year to raise any money at all. I'm excited to see the enthusiasm. I'm excited to see what Matthew Nix is going to bring to it, along with Adam Kelly and the rest of the coaching staff. I just think we've got a good group together that I think are going to do a lot of things that are going to shock some people. I can't speak highly enough of all of our entourage and staff and people that are behind them, and let's go from there.
That was your first look at our new television commercial there. You can sign up right now as a Crows AFL or AFLW member to secure your seat at the footy in 2021. You'll also get exclusive member benefits and access to even more behind-the-scenes content. Now, as you can see and hear behind us, the AFLW side, they're still training hard, led by coach, of course, Matthew Clark. We sat down with Doc for an in-depth look at what he is expecting for the season ahead. Okay, so we're still seeing some live pictures there. Just having a bit of trouble with that package from Matthew Clark. What we're going to do is speak to the new chairman of the Adelaide Football Club, John Olsen.
Well, it's clear to me this club has passionate supporters across the board who want the club to be the best it can be. And in that context, the board has developed a 18-month strategy going forward in consultation with the executive, working with the football department, to look at post this COVID-19 circumstances that we all face, to ensure that we can provide the support services to the club, and in particularly the football department, to ensure that we get on-field performance. Another observation, and I've been delighted with this, is the way in which Matthew Nix, as a senior coach, with the buy-in from the assistant coaches, has set a standard for the players. That standard is elite football requires discipline and commitment, and the players have bought into the coach's requirements. There are a number of key priorities in our plan, one of which, and an important one, is fan engagement. And how do you best engage with fans in the post-COVID environment? The rules of the game have changed, and that's where digital communication and the club being at the forefront of AFL clubs, of being able to communicate, give exclusives to the membership base of the Adelaide Football Club, engage with them and enable them to engage with us as a football club. Well, importantly, the club has maintained its financial independence. Where a number of clubs had to borrow from the AFL to continue their operations, we, the Adelaide Football Club, and to the credit of the board, sought private finance. Therefore, we have a level of independence from the AFL, and that is really important because decision-making from this club is locally based. A new facility is really important because effectively we're in a construction zone here at West Lakes. There are many components that have got to be addressed. Complex and significant work that needs to be undertaken, location, public transport, ease of access for members and fans, but also meeting the requirements of the football department. And that's why we've put the timeline of about 4 to 5 months and be able to identify where a future home might be. And this will be a home that will service the club for decades to come. So we've got to get it right.
To see and learn more about the Adelaide Footy Club, you can head to the Crows Facebook page, the Twitter account, Instagram, all the socials there, or you can visit afc.com.au. And of course, you can even see that interview with Matthew Clark that we had a few technical difficulties with, so don't miss that one there. In some other good news, I'll also be returning in 2021 with the Crows Show, so keep your eyes peeled on Channel 7 to go inside the four walls of West Lakes. We'll be doing that each and every week. And for all your Crows merchandise, the Crowmania shop, that's at West Lakes, is officially reopened, which is great news as well. You can pick up all the official team gear from O'Neill's and Cotton On, or you can head online to see the range at shop.afc.com.au. Now, all AFL games are ticketed in 2021. That's the AFLW games, I should say. So it's important to note that the best way to secure a ticket is to become a Crows AFLW member. Now, round two tickets will be available to AFLW members at 9 a.m. Monday, the 1st of February, and the general public at 11 a.m. AFLW members will be provided free entry to home games as part of their membership, while tickets are $10 to the general public. Under 18s get in for free. All attendees must redeem a ticket in advance of the match to gain entry. There will be no ticket sales at the gate. Do not forget that. Now, that's just about it from us this evening here. Thanks for joining us on Crows Live. Make sure you keep up to date with everything that's going on at the club through the social media networks, of course, and the Crows website, afc.com.au. My name is Mark Bickley. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you again.